All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahushai, Ba'ashim, Rekakwandash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well and teach well. And peace and blessings to the elect of Israel out there that's pushing this word in truth and sincerity. All right, this is going to be about the second coming of our Lord Yahushai. All right, And the fact that, you know, he's coming at as a thief in the night. I'm going to start by reading Matthew 24 and 36. But of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. All right, so this is Yahushua saying, look, like, I don't even know when I'm going to come back. All right, no one knows the exact time, like, that no one can give a date. We just see that. A lot of stuff, a lot of prophecies are starting to pop off, all right? I mean, like, you see how the weather is. There's, like, 14 different fires in California. There's been, like, six hurricanes hitting America in 1 year. I mean, that's abnormal. And, like, here in Memphis, it snowed, like, 3 days ago, and now today it was like sunny and 60, or sunny and 70, you know, like, and now the trees are just now starting to turn. Like, there's a bunch of bugged out stuff, and but no one knows exactly when he's coming back. We can just tell through the spirit that it's soon, all right, because of stuff like this. Verse 37, but as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day of Noah entered into the ark. All right, because nobody knew exactly when the flood was going to happen. All right, Noah was just told to build an ark because the flood was coming, and people weren't really. You know, the people were scoffing at him, telling him that, you know, it's not going to rain. You're crazy. And they just went on about their daily lives. That's how people are when you tell them America is going to be destroyed. All right, people just think you're crazy and go about living their normal lives. And knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Right, because people didn't realize it until it started happening. All right, matter of fact, come on. I'm going to grab that real quick. Yeah, Ezekiel 33 and 33. And when this cometh to pass, lo, it will come. Then shall they know that a prophet hath been among them. Alright, because that's when people want to get right, is when it starts to come, alright? Because even, like, people that are awake to the truth know that the RFID is coming, because we can see it, it's hitting the UK right now, but people still want to deny that it's the mark of the beast because it's not mandatory at your job yet, or your school yet, but one day it will be. You know, thus saith the scriptures, it says no man may buy or sell, lest he have the mark of the beast, which is that RFID chip. All right. Matthew 24 and 40. Then shall two be left in the field, the one shall be taken and the other left. Right. So I'm just gonna try to stick to the point that no man's gonna know exactly when. A lot of people are going to be caught off guard. This is 2 Peter 3 and 10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. That's talking about the nuclear missiles, you know, everything. The elements shall melt with fervent heat. You know, everything's being burnt up. The heavens shall pass away with a great noise. Yeah, because when those missiles explode, they're gonna be loud, man. Saying then that all these things shall be dissolved. What manner of persons ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness? All right, so now that you know that the Lord's coming back, and you know that America's gonna be destroyed with nuclear fire, and everything's gonna be done away with. You know, your job, your car, your house, whatever on this side. No, man, it's gonna be burnt up, man. So what manner of persons ought ye to be? All right. Are you gonna say YOLO and just, you know, live it up? Just party, party, party? Or are you gonna get right with the Lord? This is Revelation 16 and 15. Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watcheth and keepeth his garments, lest he walk naked and they see his shame. Right, man. Blessed is he that watcheth, you know, because we're watching for Yahushua to come back. We're on guard. We're staying up to date with these prophecies popping off. All right. We keep an eye on all these events happening. We keep up with current events and filter it through the scriptures. All right, we see that tensions are rising with Russia and America over there in the Middle East. We see that uproars are happening in America. You know, there's going to be like a civil war too. All right. And it says, and keepeth his garments, lest he walk naked, and they see his shame. And garment is symbolic for the laws, man. You're keeping the laws, statutes, and commandments to your best ability, and that we're, and the naked is symbolic for going off sinning. You know, like Adam and Eve when they were naked. Is because, you know, they went off. But this is Matthew 10 and 34. Think not that I come to send peace on earth. I come not to send peace, but a sword, right? Because there's a false notation that he's coming back with sunshine and rainbows, and just in a snap of his fingers, everybody's going to be peaceful. But no, he's coming back to destroy, like physically destroy all these wicked people. All right, the scriptures say, they shall know death by pain. They're gonna have to learn to get right through pain, man. All right, and then it goes on to say, for I come to set a man at variance against his father, and the daughter against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's foes shall be they of his own household. You know? He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. Right, man? Because you want to hold on to whatever you have in this world, man. You want to hold on to whatever relationships, which just goes to prove that you love this lifestyle more than what Yahushua has planned for you. Or Yahushua has planned for you. You're not worthy of that, man. If you want to hold on to whatever life you have in slavery, all right? Isaiah 66 and 16. For by fire and by his word, by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many. All right. So he's not coming back to with sunshine and rainbows, man. By fire and by sword, and the slain of the Lord shall be many. All right. So a lot of people are going to die, man. Yeah, I'll read into this. Second Ezra 13. This is a cold chapter, man. It's a really good one. Let's see. 13 and 3. Second Ezra 13 and 3. And I beheld, and lo, that men waxed strong with the thousands of heaven, Alright, so this is Yahweh Shai with thousands of heaven, which is his army, his angels. And when he turned his countenance to look, all the things trembled that were seen under him. Alright, so everybody that saw him were shitting their pants. Verse 4, and whensoever the voice went out of his mouth, all they burned that heard his voice, like as the earth faileth when it feeleth the fire. You know how like when you burn a piece of grass and it withers up? That's how people were when they heard his voice. They were scared, so they shriveled up. And after this I beheld, and lo, there was gathered together a multitude of men out of number from the four winds of the heaven to subdue the man that came out of the sea. Alright, so all these nations started to come up against Yahweh Shai. Because they started fighting him, man. You know? Like in the middle of World War III, you're going to have Yahweh Shai come in. And everybody's going to stop fighting each other and start fighting what they're going to try to make it out to be an alien invasion. But it's really going to be Yahweh Shai and his angels. But I beheld, and lo, he had graved himself a great mountain and flew up upon it. Alright? So that's his chariot. It's that great mountain. You know, what they call UFOs. But I would have seen the region or place where out the hill was graven, and I could not. So that's how big it was. He couldn't see where it ended and began. And after this, I beheld, and lo, all they which were gathered together to subdue him were sore afraid, and yet durst fight. And lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, he neither lifted up his hand, nor held sword, nor any instrument of war. But only I saw that he sent out of his mouth, as it had been a blast of fire, and out of his lips a flaming breath, and out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempest. Alright, so that was him using spiritual power, man, like superpowers. He just, you know, opened up his mouth and it blasts of fire just came out of his mouth and did wipe them out. Alright, it said, and they were all mixed together, the blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest, and fell with violence upon the multitude which was prepared to fight, and burned them up every one, so that upon a sudden of an innumerable multitude, nothing was to be perceived. But only dust and smell of smoke. When I saw this, I was afraid. Yeah, man, that's a terrifying vision to see. There's somebody flying up on a UFO, a so-called UFO, and he opens his mouth and just a freaking laser beam shoots out of his mouth and hits all these people, and nothing's left of them except for dust and smoke. That is terrifying. And that's what Yahweh Shai is coming back to do. You know, he's coming back to whoop ass, man. I'm going to end it with this. I wanted to end it with that. So like, yeah. But yeah, man. Yahweh Shai is coming back real soon. We don't know exactly when. Alright? But that's why we got to keep watching for these things. Keep up to date with what prophecies are coming to pass, man. You can see through the spirit that this economy is about to collapse. Alright, so keep studying, keep looking out for prophecies. Show brotherly love to one another. Alright, and with that, I hope this video was edifying, and shalom.